Hey everybody, Melon here. Today we're going to be doing a disassembly guide for the Keychron M3 Mini 4K. Now this will be applicable for the Keychron M3 Mini as they are the exact same mice, so the disassembly process is exactly the same. Now just a note, as I always say, do not take this apart if this is under the first year warranty with Keychron, because disassembling the unit will void your warranty. So do not take it apart unless you absolutely have to. It will void your warranty. If you want to replace batteries and that kind of stuff, do it outside of the 1 year warranty, or and if you have an issue within the first year, send it back to Keychron. Let's go ahead and get right into it. Alrighty, now the first step for taking apart the M3 Mini 4K is going to be removing the stock skates. Now I've already removed my stock skates and replaced them with extra padded obsidian dots, but just keep in mind when you do remove them, you will need to put something else on there. You don't need to remove the top ones, you only need to remove the bottom ones, but just make sure you have something to replace them when you do this. So all you have to do is take apart these two star-headed screws down here. I'm going to go ahead and do that right now. Now that you have the base screws out, the best way to open this up is just going to be putting a little pressure on both sides here, and that should crack the bottom open. And you can run your fingernail over or a pry bar along the edges to release all the clips. Once that's done, all you have to do is basically just pull the mouse open, but you want to pull it open from the top of the unit, not from the back. So just go ahead and gently pull up here. And everything should come apart just like that. Now, I'm glad this happened. This will happen a lot. The side buttons will come loose during the removal process. They're very easy to reassemble, but I'll talk about that in a minute. Another thing that may also come loose sometimes is this little side daughter PCB for the actual side clicks. Those are very easy just to pop back into place. So if it does come loose, don't worry about it. So the bottom is pretty straightforward. The first thing you're gonna wanna do is remove this side panel here. And then there is a little 3-pin connector on the bottom here, which you can just pull off very easily. And that's your daughter board. Next up, you have the battery. You're going to go ahead and disconnect that, which is again, just another tri-tip connector. And then next up, we're going to go ahead and take off this main board here. So the first two screws are going to be at the bottom here. And then the other two screws are going to be at the top of the mouse here, just right next to the main clicks. You're going to go ahead and remove those next. Now that's done, you should be able to remove the board from the bottom of the mouse. So you're just going to go ahead and pull it up from the bottom a little bit here, and it should just pop right off just like that. Now you will probably have one or two pieces fall from the bottom. Don't worry about that. We'll deal with that in a second. Now, when you pull it off, just make sure you pull it straight up, because you do have to pull it off the stand-ups here for the scroll wheels. Just make sure you pull it straight up when you do remove it. So what fell off here was the power button. So this actually little slider just kind of sits right here and it just kind of slides between all the modes, but we'll talk about that in a minute. And now in terms of the top shell, there really isn't too much to talk about here. In order to remove the main clicks, it's very easy. All you do is just put a little pressure on the side and pull up from the top, and they just basically just fall right out, which is nice and easy. So that's how you take care of the side buttons. And then in terms of removing the main clicks, it's very simple. There's just screws here and here, which we'll remove right now. In order to get the clicks out, all you have to do is just put a little pressure underneath both sides here, and the clicks will pop right off. And then the clicks will literally fall out of the shell. They're very easy to take out, and you can just take out the main clicks like this and this. Again, be very careful removing these. If they don't just immediately come out, don't put pressure on them, because you can break the stabilizers on them. So just be very, very, very careful when removing these. Now, the last thing you can remove from the central shell is this little shaft here. Now, what this does is that this takes the light that is on the middle part of this PCB right here, because this is the indicator LED. It takes the light from that and carries it up this to the top button here. Now, you will never need to remove this, so I wouldn't worry about removing it, but you can take it off if you really want to. Alrighty, now let's go through the reassembly process. Now let's deal with putting the clicks back into the unit. So I'm gonna go ahead and grab these here and grab this. So what we're gonna do in order to get them actually into the shells, we're gonna go ahead and put the end of the click into the shell here. We're gonna just let it naturally line up. And then what we're gonna do is once we get it in, we're gonna put it onto here and then just press down, and you should feel a little click that will kind of anchor the clicks into place. Same process for this one. And then once that's in, we're gonna go ahead and push down, and that will anchor it into place. All right, then you wanna take the very short, tiny little screw we took this out of earlier, and we're gonna go ahead and put that into the central spot right here, and then you're just gonna gently turn these in. Now again, be very careful not to over-tighten these screws, because if you over-tighten them, you will damage the actual shell mouse itself, but they should feel a little bit of actuation towards the end. They should have a nice rebound to them. So that's all you have to do for there. All right, now all you have to do for these side buttons, they're actually probably the easiest thing. You literally just kind of put them back into place and they just kind of naturally figure it out. You will probably have to bend like one side into the actual clip holder like that, but they're very loose. Like they just kind of sit there, but they're very easy to take out and put it back in. All right, now let's do the main board. Now the battery is glued on with some adhesive, which is why I didn't remove it. But if you do want to remove it, you can just take it off. It's very easy to do so. Now what we're gonna do first is we're gonna go ahead and put this back onto this middle track right here. Now we're gonna put it all the way to the right and keep in mind what we're gonna do with that. Next up, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go to the PCB and we're gonna go to the bottom, and this little slider here, we're gonna move this all the way to the left. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and put this back on. Now make sure that this power slider stays in this current position. Basically what you wanna do is you just wanna take the PCB, kind of put it in like this, line it up with the two holes towards the back, and then just gently drop it on top like this. Now at this point, I would put your finger right here and make sure that this power slider is working properly before you do anything else. So make sure that's in. Once that's in, you're good to go. Now, if it does not go on naturally, it's probably because this slipped at some point during your reinstallation. Do not force it on, because if you force it on, you're gonna break that little slider on the bottom of the PCB here. So just make sure this works before you do anything else. Next up, what you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna wanna go ahead and put the screws back in. And again, these are the slightly longer, thinner screws we used earlier. And they are going to go one, they're gonna go two at the bottom here. Now again, be sure not to over tighten these screws. Make sure that once they kind of give a little bit of feedback, make sure to stop turning. Don't overturn them or you will damage your unit and you could potentially bend your board. Now next up, we're going to take this battery connector. We're going to go ahead and plug that in. So this is just a very easy plug. All you got to do is just basically wrap this cable around and just plug it in right there, and it should just click in with no problem. Next up, we can do the side buttons. Again, very simple as well. Take this 3-pin connector, put it in towards the top here, and then that just goes in right into here. And then you can just push it down with your fingernail and just kind of let it sit into place. There's that. And then you just want to take this and just slide this into this secondary holder right here like that. And make sure the orientation stays like this. Don't flip the board upside down. Now, in terms of getting the back shell back on, all you have to do is take these two little clips here and line them up with these two little clips towards the front of the mouse itself. So you're going to go ahead and kind of just gently put everything in. Gently put everything, make sure everything's oriented properly when you do the reassembly. At some point, it will just kind of naturally fit itself in. And then what you do is you can go ahead and push this down, put a little bit of pressure towards the front. You should hear a click, and you can click down the rest of the shell and everything should just naturally click in just like that. All the clips will go in. Now, before you screw the unit back together, be sure to check that all your buttons are working. So check the base buttons, check this to make sure obviously the unit power is on. Check your main clicks, check your scroll wheel click, check your side buttons. Make sure everything actuates before you fully reassemble it. But if everything checks out and the unit turns on, all you have to do is take these longer star-headed screws that we took out initially. Take this and put these into the bottom back here and here. And then now you can reapply your stock skates or put on aftermarket skates, whatever you prefer, whatever is easiest for you to do. But that is everything for taking apart the Keychron M3 Mini 4K and the M3 Mini. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you do have any questions about the teardown I don't cover in this video, be sure to let me know down in the comments. I'll do my best to fill you in there. And that is pretty much everything. Get subscribed to the channel for more teardowns in the future. And if you do want to see a review of this mouse, which is actually quite surprising, probably one of the best budget mice I've seen this year, I do have a full review of it over on my channel. You can go check out if you're interested. But that is all for today. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace.